Sherry, you may leave. Go ahead for your class.
What's going on tonight? Here are our announcements for today. We'd like to take this opportunity to welcome all guests. Thank you for coming and worshiping with us here at True Life Community Worship Center. We count on the blessing that you decided to join us today. You should have received a welcome packet, and within your welcome packet is a guest card. We ask that you fill out the guest card, tell us a little bit about yourself, and please include your contact information so that we can keep you informed about what's going on here at True Life. We thank you for coming, and we look forward to seeing you again. Join us for a fun and exciting week as we celebrate our church anniversary. Join us for Fellowship Week. Starting on Thursday, April 5th, we will have So You Think You Can Bowl, bowling competition, located at Terrace Bowling Alley in Temple Terrace. On Friday, April the 6th, we will have our Friday night praise service featuring Apostle Ruth Mobley, starting at 7 p.m. On Saturday, we will have Family Fun Day at Rolette Park, starting at 11 a.m. And on Sunday, which will be Family and Friends Day, we will top it off with our finale service featuring guest speaker and pastor James Chappelle from Hartford Family Ministries. So we ask that you join us for this fun and exciting week as we celebrate another year of True Life Community Worship Center. We look forward to seeing you there. This fourth Sunday will be Palm Sunday, and we will recognize Jesus' triumphal entry. Feel free to wear your palm green attire to recognize this special occasion. We have officially launched True Life University, or True U. Classes will begin Sunday mornings at 9 a.m. True Life University will explore some of the deepest questions about our faith and engage participants with relevant and exciting topics. So join us on Sunday mornings at 9 a.m. for this exciting and new exploration of our faith. That concludes our announcement. We look forward to seeing you.
Yes. Sing hallelujah. Hallelujah. Listen, can we do this here? Can give me some worship music? Y'all stand for me just for a minute. Just begin to just worship God just for a few minutes. Just for a few minutes. Just for a few minutes. Just worship. Come on, worship Him. Come on, open your spirit and worship Him. Worship Him. Brother Joe, can you give me something else? Some strings or something? Give me something else. Come on, let's go a little bit deeper with this. Come on, I need 2 minutes of just intimate worship. Come on. Release the weight that you've been carrying. All the things that you've been facing before you got here. I need my warriors, friend. I need my warriors. Come on. Come on, let the Lord hear you today. Come on.
People walk on. Jesus. You know, Jesus' name is a midnight call. You know, in your midnight hour, when you feel like you've been misunderstood, and come on, somebody. When you feel like you can't even understand what you're going through, come on, somebody. So how do you expect somebody else to understand who you are? Because you don't even understand.
For which cause we faint not,
But though our outward man perish, yet the inward man is renewed day by day. Somebody say, for our light affliction, say my light affliction, which is but for a moment, tell somebody just for a moment, it worketh for us a far more exceedingly and eternal weight of glory. Come on, give God some praise in this house. Glory to God. Today, if I could, I want to talk to the church, the body today. And I want to talk to you about this because I believe that God would deem it to be so, to encourage us in such a time as this and the things that we're dealing with and we're going through. How many of you know that we could continuously see something going on every single day? If it's not by the news, somebody giving you a phone call, whatever it is, something is constantly going on. How many of y'all are aware of the times of it? How many of you really know what day, what time it is?
Amen.
Do you really know that?
Amen.
How many really know that Jesus is returning soon? How many of y'all really understand that?
Amen.
He is. And so I say that to say that it's imperative that we get beyond the superficial things and the minor things and the distractions that come against us. And we must make sure that we do our job and our due diligence to proclaim the glory of the Lord, to declare who God is. Surrender. I tell people this all the time. It's so imperative that you bring the kingdom to the earth, right? And so that means that we must follow the instructions of God. We must do what God say do. We must obey what he tells us to do. We must follow his word. We must seek his face. We must make sure that everywhere we go, we're setting an example. Tell somebody, I need to set an example for the kingdom. We got to set an example for the kingdom of the Lord. Everywhere you go, you should be setting an example for the kingdom of the Lord. Everywhere we go, we should be setting an example for the kingdom of the Lord. So every time you feel like your example has been tainted or contaminated, you need to check that because it means that you have backed up on what God really called you to do. Now let me tell you something important because a lot of us think that's all about being a title. It's not about you being a minister. Oh, come on, somebody. It ain't about your title. It ain't about you being a pastor. It's not about you being a father. Don't get me wrong. We respect the fivefold ministry and God put them in place for a purpose and a reason. But at the end of the day, and I want you to really hear this. Hear this, church. If you have all of that, but you don't know how to love, you ain't got none. I'm preaching already right now. I'm all about building and moving things forward. But if you feel like your time won't get you to heaven, you're wrong.
Amen.
There's a lot of people that are going to bust hell wide open with a title. Oh, God. I'm preaching already. Oh, I'm talking already. And I want you to get this because I don't want you to get stuck on the wrong things. We get so stuck on gifts. And I'm all with it. Hear what I'm saying. I understand the gifts. I understand what God's trying to do. But don't you get it twisted that you're so stuck on that gift and you ain't got nothing on the inside. You still haven't gotten the basis yet. Oh, God.
Amen.
Listen, one of the most important things that I tell people all the time is, listen, God has made an investment in you. He's made an investment in us. He made an investment in you. He made an investment when he said, listen, I'm calling you before the foundation, before the formation of the world. I've already spoken you into existence. I've already called you to be here. But let me tell you something. He didn't call you just for you to operate in gifts. Oh, come on, somebody. That's not what he called you for. He gave you that as an enhancement of his glory and to prove to people that his power is real. I'm preaching already. He called us so that we can show forth his love and show forth his power. That's what God called you for. So if you don't ever, can I just give you this? If you don't ever flow in a gift, now here's what I want you to understand. Obviously, the closer you draw nigh to God, he draws nigh to you. And yes, things will come and a manifestation of the fruit of who you are will manifest. Oh, man. Y'all ain't ready for me today. It will come forth. But here's what I want you to understand. What good is it for you to have a title or for you to have a gift and then you can't even love or you can't even have, listen, you can't even have brotherly kindness as the word say. We say we love God so much. Everything that Christ did was about his love. Everything he taught was about his love. Everything he brought to the table was about his love. I contend if the whole church would learn how to love like in the image of God,
I'm not
them show. Come on now. You know what that is like? She said, well, yeah, all of them. I'm with you right now. You understand? That favorite thing that we tend to watch and those kind of things, and we'll say to ourselves, we meant to tell ourselves, you know what? I'm going to watch this, and then when I get to watch it, I'm going to spend time with the Lord. Let me give you another one. We'll say, you know what? I'm going to get up early. And then you know what the enemy will do? Because he wants us to stay in this place of shallowness. He'll make us so weary the night before that we almost sleep in the morning. And then we almost sleep, and then we almost sleep. Don't we do? We rush in to get to what? Work. Or we rush in to get to whatever the agenda is. Right? And so we don't even. So what we find ourselves doing sometimes, but those that's on this level, amen, I'm praying for you, we'll say, okay, well, let me just get a little devotion. But God will say, no, I want more than just a devotion with you. I want to spend time with you. And I want you to spend time with me. Because God is trying to get us to do what? Build a relationship with him.
Yes, yes.
Huh? So shallowness. And why is it? Because the world has become so commercialized. And this is a word that God helped me with. He said, because we've become so commercialized, he said, and the world is so wicked with secularization. In other words, secular things, the secular things of the world is so pushed an agenda of everything that's worldly and secular and worldly and secular and worldly and secular. I had somebody tell me a story, and they were telling me about a young lady. And I was grieved, and I said, God, that's really touching my spirit. And I said, God, I gotta get to her because I wanna talk to her. But this young lady is talented, she's gifted, talented, grew up in the church, but is finding herself now wanting to do and pattern the ways of the world. She knows who God is. We know who God is. We know what God wants, but she has found herself now in this whirlwind where everything is about pleasure. It's about the success of money. It's about doing things the way that we see it on television and the image and the hype, and I want to do it this way, and I want to do it this way, and I want to do it this way. Now listen to me, I don't mind, and I get and I understand doing nice things, but can I be honest with you all? Some church. The truth of the matter is, when we get to a point though, where whatever it is we're doing, it comes to the point where it causes any kind of approach against God's word of the kingdom of God, your best interest is to not do it.
Amen. Amen.
Now talk to believers now, right? We talk to church folk, right? The Bible declares all things are what? Lawful, but not expedient. So it means some things just ain't in our best interest.
That's right.
Let me break it down to you. Some things ain't good for us. Come on, somebody. Some things ain't the best thing for us to do. That's why we're having trouble. We make decisions from our head and not our heart. Because in your heart, you don't hide God's word. In your mind, sometimes your mind trip out, and it makes you do things, do decisions that God said I ain't had to do with that. Oh, come on. Help me hold it. So we must understand that this place, when the enemy's trying to get us to be spiritually deteriorated, the whole purpose of what he's trying to do is to get us to become ineffective and unproductive right now. He wants you ineffective and unproductive. He wants you ineffective and unproductive. Listen, and I'm not talking about just coming here with praise and worship. I'm not talking about just coming here and looking down here, but you know what? It's easy, and I tell people all the time, you come in here, even on those days, praise the Lord, when we got to push a little bit. Because you can feel the spirit of heaviness. Everybody's not necessarily on one accord or on that post. You recognize, you know what it is. For those of you that walk in the spirit, you get it. But if you do, then that means you should be praying and interceding.
Glory be to God.
Why? Because God is saying, listen, we as the body, we have become so familiar. We want the familiar, we want the comfortable, we want the common, we want the logical, we want the tangible things in life. Oh, can I say it again? Because I know I'm hitting you wrong. Listen to me. We want the familiar. We want things that we know. That's all we want to do. God is saying, listen, we're time, you got to do things out of radical. You got to tell somebody, you got to get radical now. You got to step out the box. You got to do things like you never did before. It's time to change things. We want the familiar, the things that we're constantly doing. But then y'all know, we talk about this all the time. In order for you to grow in God's sin, take me, you can't keep doing what you were doing last year. God is not taking you to something that's new, something that's different. I'm promoting your sin to the new place that I call for you. Not the familiar, not the same people, not the same things, not doing the same things. I'm calling you to something that's not familiar. Something that's not familiar to you. That's the first thing you need to say. Then we want to be comfortable. Everybody want to be comfortable. Everybody want the convenience of being comfortable. I want everything to be comfortable. I don't want to feel nothing. I don't want to go through nothing. I just want things to be comfortable. I want every day to be comfortable. I don't want to be challenged by nothing. I don't want to go through nothing. I just want every day to be comfortable. I want every day to be peace and security. I want every day, I just want the sun to shine. I don't want no rain in my life. I don't want no storm in my life. I just want to go through what's comfortable. Why are you going to talk when they're going to do the same thing? But yet God said, But God said, listen, but it doesn't make sense. And that's what makes me God. Because the God in you will help you to turn the other cheek and bless the Lord anyhow. And say, you know what? You still won't make my enemies be brothers good. But even though you're slapping on both sides of my way, I still got joy. I still see God. And God is still going to give me what I deserve. Oh, come on, somebody. And so it doesn't make sense. And so we don't understand when God puts things together and when there's a plan that he puts together for our lives. A lot of times it just don't make sense. But when God's instruction and his process challenges us, it's because it is shifting us to the unusual. You can write these down. The uncomfortable, the unfamiliar, the non-logical, and the unexplainable. It's because he is provoking production of change within us. He's taking us to a place of unusual, uncomfortable, unfamiliar. Come on, somebody. Non-logical and unexplainable. It's because he's provoking the production of change within us. Listen, I'm almost done. I'll leave about 15 more minutes. Come on, bless the Lord. Is that all right? I hope y'all get some out of this. I hope y'all get some out of this. I'm telling you. Listen, we got to understand because, and this is what God shared with me. He said a lot of us today, we're just living in the moment. We're just living in the moment. Every day, our daily process is just in the moment. We have a routine. We get up at a certain time. We do certain things at a certain time. We do this at a certain time. For those of you that have a more structured life, now some of y'all are living in the moment and you're unstructured. But that's a whole other preach word. Because you need to understand that God is structure and there's order. You get those kind of things right, I promise you, you'll see a difference in your life. But here it is. We have this process of doing things. We do this, we do that, those kind of things. But watch this. So God is helping us understand. Listen, it's not about living the moment, but it's about our determination to grow from every intentional and purposeful movement of moment. Because it's shaping our destiny. Watch this. Everything that God is doing in those moments, you got to recognize that whatever it is that he's doing, he's trying to get your attention. So you. The whole time he's moving. It was a moment of movement. God said it was a moment of movement. It was a moment of movement. Now, the only way we move is how we respond to the moment that God gives us to move in. I hope y'all stand with me. See, God had to hear and help me understand. He said, listen. He said, I'm just gonna bang on the words. Go y'all with me. He said, every time you had those moments that seemed like it was bumping at you and tossing and turning you, and those times when you were saying, "But I just don't understand this," and those times you were saying, "Well, God, really, where are you and what are you doing?" Or you were saying, "But my, you know, my intentions were sincere, but yet you still made wrong decisions." God said, every single time, everything he does in time is a part of a movement from forward. Every divorce, even though God is not God of war, God said, but you know what? Even in that, so you got to find those things that we think that God can't move in. Come on, somebody. I'm trying to help you. I'm trying to give you some strength. God is saying, listen, I'm greater than what you had to leave behind. For whatever reason you had to leave it, for whatever reason you had to walk away from it, for whatever reason it couldn't happen no more. Listen, God said, but listen, at the end of the day, I need you to move forward in the moment. I need you to move forward in the moment. I need you to walk away from what happened, walk away from what didn't happen, walk away from what was said, what wasn't said, and move forward. Tell somebody moving forward. Tell today I'm convicted to move forward. Ah, bless God. Listen, I'm almost done. And so with that, listen, we cannot continue to afford to hold on to our lower nature and our unmanaged mindsets. Y'all ever heard the expression? That a man should, it says a man's mind can match life. You ever heard that? Maybe not. But they said, if you got a man's mind, and what it's trying to say is, if your mind is moving forward, and if it's focused, and if it has a due diligence, for those of you that are workaholics or they really believe in, you know, your jobs and things you do and those kind of things, and even in ministry, whatever it is, but when your mind is focused, when you're focused, you move forward. You move. You'll get your best, the best dance will come when your mind is focused. You know what I'm saying? The praise team, the best singing unto the Lord God when your mind is focused. The best thing when you will stand up delivering the word of God when your mind is focused. You can be the best doorkeeper when your mind is focused, but when your mind is not. When you don't put your head in the game instead of your true heart for God. When your mind is messed up because your mind is on what's at home or what you love or what you got to go back to. Come on, son. Oh, I'm talking to you. When your mind is on that thing, that very thing you keep saying, God, when are you going to deliver me out of this? When are you going to take care of this? When are you going to change this? You ever been around people and you know your hair was messed up but you were still acting like you were all together? Oh, come on, I'm talking to you. I know what I'm talking about. See, the problem is we can't see what's really in your head. See, I got this expression. This expression is, I can see bubbles over your head. So you be talking to me, and the Spirit will let me know exactly where your mind is, what you're thinking, where that came from. Uh-oh. Those are true spirit walkers. Come on here. And then I know in my mind what to pray for your deliverance, and what to pray for that God will loose you from, so that you can have your mind free.
real.
Oh, yes, if we don't want to be transparent, that's what's wrong with us. We want to act like we just fell out of heaven, like we just some superstar, and we've been some super saint all our life. The devil in the life, you ain't that saint. You got something, you just don't like what people are doing. So you want people to think you something you really ain't. Thank you, Jesus. happening. Let me read this real quick. He said, listen, he said in the second verse, he said, my brother, count it all joy when we fall into diverse temptation.
Yes, sir.
Let me say, listen, consider it all holy joy for my brother when you have encountered trials of any sort and fall into various temptation. Tell your neighbors that sometimes we're going to fall. Sometimes.